skin that smoke wagon and see what happens.
How's that for a slice of fried gold?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know how this machine worked.
It seems to run on some form of electricity.
And it was wrong. It was a bad call, Ripley. It was a bad call.
Bad call.
Some are good for fighting, others for dying.
It's Just Two Movies.
Welcome back to another episode of It's Just Two Movies. My name is Daniel King. In the studio with me this evening, Justin!
Thank you.
Ross!
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Sorry, I had like eight beers before we sat down in here.
That was interesting.
Welcome back to the show.
What an entrance, man.
If it's your first time listening to the show, I'm sorry about your car speakers. And also, we watched two movies. One of them's good. One of them, is it good? I don't know. Either of them, are they good? What's good, really? It's all preference anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
Yes.
But I tell you what, we are going to have some drinks and have ourselves a real dandy of a time, knee slapper. This week was your selection,
yes,
right? And yeah, you chose the movie Goon.
I did,
which I had been really excited to like this is on a list I had somewhere, and I was like, one day I'm going to revisit this for the show because this is fun. Goon is a 2011 R-rated comedy sport film, 1 hour, 32-minute runtime. You can watch it for free on Pluto. It's got a 6.8 out of 10, an 81% on Rotten Tomatoes, and a 3.3 out of 5 on Letterboxd. 83% of Google users like this movie. Released March 30th, 2012, directed by Michael Douse. Budget was $12 million. Box office was only $7 million, which isn't that a shame?
I agree, yeah. I mean, it could have made more than that, but it didn't, so here we are.
Screenplay written by Jay Baruchel and Evan Goldberg. This stars Sean William Scott, Jay Baruchel, Marc-Andre Grodin, that's probably Mark, Marc-Andre Grodin, guy in leather jacket, great.
Right.
Liev Schreiber, Allison Pill, Eugene Levy, Kim Coates, Ricky Mabe, David Petiku, Jonathan Cherry, George Charkov, Richard Clarkin, Elaine David, and that is pretty much it. I do also want to give a shout out to George Larac. George Larac, best guess. Sorry to our friends of the North there while I'm butchering your French. I also didn't know on my first watch that all the guys from Trailer Park Boys are in this.
Right, yeah.
How fun is that? Yeah, just one cameo, and then they're not in the rest of it.
Yeah, just 2-3 minute scene tops. Yeah.
They just were like, oh, I fucking love hockey.
Right, yeah.
Hilarious stuff, man. Really liking it. So, Jay Bone, if someone had never seen Goon and they're like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? What would you say it's about?
It's about some dude that he's kind of an idiot, and he can fight. And he can't play hockey worth a shit, but since he can fight, the coach wants to put him on the team. So
turns out that's a part of hockey. And if nobody on your hockey team can fight, having one guy that can, pretty advantageous.
Yeah, for sure. You got that enforcer out there. So, you know, he starts learning how to skate and play hockey and, you know, does pretty good.
Yeah.
Especially at fighting. Man, he beats the shit out of some guys in this.
I was going to say, man, some of the violence in this is outstanding.
Right.
And some of it, very comical. It's a weird blend. It's a weird blend, and it's a fun movie. So we're going to go full spoilers into this the rest of the way. Let's go ahead and go into it. Full spoilers. No holds barred. So this is the kind of movie that, like what you said, is what happens. What you imagine in this movie happens.
Right.
So I'm going to rush through it real quick, and then we're just going to talk about the stuff that we liked. This really would have been like a really opportune summer break type of episode, but I think we might default to that format for like 90% of our, like 90% of our stuff from now on. Just to kind of speed things up. I have changed careers and I get home a little later than usual, and I don't want to make anybody else stay up until 2 o'clock in the morning recording this stupid fucking show. So
I appreciate that.
Mm, Oh, not you. Not tonight. You're fucking here forever.
Sounds good. That's what I was hoping for.
One of us. One of us. All right. So, yeah, what you've got is Sean William Scott. He's a bouncer at a bar, and he feels like an underachiever because his gay brother is a doctor. I only say his gay brother is gay because they mention it like 1,000 times in the movie.
They do. It's part of the movie.
Yeah, it is definitely part of the movie. His dad is Eugene Levy, and his mom is another person, and they're not proud of him.
His dad's also a doctor.
Yeah, it feels like he's a failure. One night, him and his buddy Jay Burdenshell, Bruchnell, whatever I said his name was, I don't know, I said it right earlier, probably. They go to a hockey game, and he's eating a bunch of corn dogs.
He is
like a ridiculous amount of corn dogs.
Three or four corn dogs.
Yeah, he does. And then later, he's like, I'll come back to it. The jokes in this movie are outstanding, but they're at a hockey game, and one of the hockey players uses a slur for gay, and right. He's like, "Hey, take that back, my brother's gay," and he absolutely beats the dog shit out of this dude when he's like, "Fuck you, man!"
Yeah,
beats the shit out of him.
He really
and his,
does.
His buddy has like a public access TV show called Hot Ice.
Yeah.
It seems really funny. He just cusses his ass off.
He does. sexual jokes, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Nonstop.
And then the coach of that team that they went to go watch calls in and he's like, "Hey, why don't you come on down to the rink and try out from a team?" And he goes out there and he fucking goes to try out for the team. Everybody's making fun of him and he beats the shit out of half of the team. He gives him the job. He does really well. He promotes him. He goes up to the big leagues. Are those real hockey teams?
No, you're not talking NHL or anything. It's like the higher up. It's like right below the NHL.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
But so it's Canadian's version of that.
Gotcha.
AHL, I think, is what it's called.
Yeah, so they send him up to that, and, you know, he gets a teammate, and this guy, will he get it together? Oh, he does eventually at the last game. Imagine that.
Right.
And he beats the shit out of a lot of people along the way and meets a hockey legend. And they kind of respectfully are like, "We do the same thing and we're going to have to fight each other."
Yeah.
And then they also do that. And then he along the way, he meets a girl and they fall for each other. And he gets his ass whooped quite a bit there at the end. And then he comes back and does more ass whooping.
Man, he gets his ass whooped by taking a puck to the face,
which
is brutal.
That's what happens for the whole story of this. There ain't no point on us spending 45 minutes going over that.
Right.
But I do want to talk about a bunch of this. First off, I want to start out with like his friendship with Jay Burchnell or whatever his name is.
Right.
I should have it pulled up in front of me, but I don't. And also, I'm kind of drunk, so it's fine.
His name is Pat.
Oh, Pat. Yeah, his friendship with
Pat. In the movie.
Yeah. Man, they have a nice friendship.
Doug Glatt, they do.
Yeah, Doug Glatt and Pat.
That's right.
Glatt and Pat, huh?
That's what they are, yeah.
Fuck, that's funny.
Man, he's hilarious. All he's ever doing is he's talking sexual one way or another.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That actually comes across in audio. That right. That was. I think that joke translates. Yeah. That's a good one.
Yeah, he's doing that so many times throughout the movie. Yeah, whenever he's out there and he's first coming out to try out for the team.
Oh, dude, he's humping stuff. He's cussing at everybody. He's yeah. So Boston.
Haven't you ever seen women's ice skates or whatever he says whenever because they're making fun of him, you know?
Figure skates,
exactly. And he says, you know, what number do you want? He says, take 69.
It's hilarious. Yeah,
exactly.
So he does. He's like, yeah, you know, my friend says, it's funny. Is that number available?
Right.
quiet. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man, it's funny shit. And like we were saying, the violence in this, like when they have him fighting.
Right.
God damn it, it's hilarious.
It is.
It's hilarious.
I love it.
It must be exhausting playing an idiot all the time. You know what I mean? Like being cast for every role. Like, hey, just do Stifler.
Right. Yeah, that's what he's doing, a lot of that.
Yeah, that's very true.
He's just a dumbass. But He's like one of the nicest guys, you know. He's like, he doesn't want to fight people, but that's what he's good at. So that's what he does.
Yeah, it's very Waterboy.
Right. Yeah. Kind of, yeah.
It's a more relatable water boy.
Right.
Or maybe less relatable. I'm not sure. The joke is that I'm retarded. Anyway.
Something exciting going on outside, I guess.
It's probably the fucking yotes. God damn. Yeah, sorry about the dogs fucking going bananas. I live in the woods.
It happens.
What do you want? Of course I have dogs. We have fucking coyotes and cocaine bears and all kinds of just not good stuff you don't want to fuck with. So anyway, in this movie, the level of I guess like unawareness that he has in this, I almost don't like it, and then I like it.
Yeah, he almost feels like he's too dumb.
Yeah.
Know? Like, he couldn't possibly be that dumb on some of the stuff.
Well, when those guys are shit-talking on him, and he's like, you don't do the thing that you just said or whatever, he could have just been like, fuck you.
Yeah,
that sounds like a thing a normal man would say.
Yeah, especially one that's dumb. He just, go fuck yourself, you know? He can hide behind that, you know what I mean?
I have a note when he's playing hockey. There's somebody in the stands, and they have a sign that says "Glat is Hebrew for fuck you."
Yeah, I do too. I saw that same thing.
Oh man, that's funny. That's when
his parents are, his Jewish parents are in the stands during that.
Oh, they're very not happy or not impressed with what he's up to.
No, not man, even.
At let all. Me pull up my notes here. I've just been talking about this without even having my fucking notes up.
Are we to the point where you want to start talking about what you like, or are we still talking about?
No, you just talking about
his buddy.
Like what you Jay. Like about it.
And there's a bunch of stuff about this movie.
Let's talk a little bit about his buddy that he's living with after he gets called up to the not big leagues.
Dude.
Xavier LaFlemme.
Yeah. LaFlemme. They call him all kinds of different shit throughout the movie to give him shit.
Oh, he's just banging hookers and doing cocaine, and he is.
He is, yeah.
For a lot of it.
Yeah, you see, the first time he meets him, he comes up to the apartment, he knocks on the door, and he just goes in, and there's titties there, and he's snorting coke off her or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's, he gets up, makes him close the door. Later, him and his other friend comes to visit Jay.
Yeah.
And Pat, rather, comes to visit. And they're spitting at each other in the apartment. Him and LaFlemme are spitting at each other. Ridiculous. Glatt gets spat right on his face. Man.
Oh, yeah.
Disgusting.
Dude, this is closer towards the end. Like, they've had a tiff, like a little lover's quarrel or whatever. And Doug Glatt's laying in bed, and LaFlemme's laying in bed, but they sleep opposite sides of the wall, you know? So he punches the wall, and he's like, hey, man, look, you don't have to say anything, but I feel like I have a special light inside my tummy, and I feel like you also have a special light inside your tummy, like E.T., and if we work together, we can phone home anywhere. And just the fucking speech he gives them, I'm like, man, they are really dedicated to him just being stupid as shit.
I know, dude.
Like, full send, just make him as dumb as possible, but, like, not in a funny way, because he's dumb funny and, like, role models.
Right.
He's dumb, but he's sharp enough to be funny.
Right.
In this, he's just dumb.
Yeah.
But there's something so endearing about how dumb he is.
Right.
Because when he is like, no, I like this. I like doing this. It gives me purpose. I feel like I belong. I genuinely connect with the guy.
Right. Exactly.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, he feels real, but I don't know about his acumen, I guess. He seems off. I maybe I've just never met anybody quite like Doug Glatt.
Right, exactly. And it might be the case, but he is, man, he's dumb. But like I said, he's like, he'd do anything for you, one of the nicest guys you ever meet. Like, doesn't want to hurt people, whatever, which is the complete opposite thing of what he does, because he just beats the shit out of people.
Complete opposite of fucking my boy, Liev Schreiber.
Yeah, man.
Goddamn, Liev Schreiber is fucking intimidating.
He is. He really is.
He really is. When they sit down at that diner together, and he's like, I respect you, whatever that means, you know? But he fucking crossed me out there on that ice, and so help me God, I will fucking lay you out. I was like, man, gave me goosebumps. I was like, he just looks so fucking intense. You know what I mean?
He really does. Yeah, his facial hair does a lot for him.
You remember when he played Sabretooth in that X-Men movie?
Yeah. Dude, I wonder if that's from that.
I don't know, man. He's got that thick-ass fucking handlebar mustache. God damn, he looks like he fucking beat up a whole bar full of dudes.
Yeah, well, he did. That's what he's known for. Man, at the beginning of the movie, you see him beating the shit out of that dude with a stick right across the head. That's how he got suspended or whatever. Yeah,
and he's like, I'm sorry. There's no excuse for it. But he's like doing an apology tour or whatever, kind of for beating the ever-living fuck out of a dude.
Right.
And then just to do it again next week.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Old Dougie, when they're going to the bar, he finally meets that girl named Eva.
Yeah.
I don't know. How do I say this delicately? He's got zero game. Except some other dude was bothering her and he knocked her out and then was like, you're pretty. He just said she was pretty like 85 times.
Yeah. She was into it.
Yeah. Yeah. And that worked, I guess. Turns out she's got a boyfriend.
Right.
And yeah. She's a bad girlfriend. And then eventually they go watch him play hockey.
Man, when he...
The boyfriend kind of figures it out. She leaves him.
Right.
And then he goes to the boyfriend's house and lets him beat the shit.
Yeah.
He just kneels in the snow and lets the boyfriend beat the shit out of
him.
Yeah,
hits him 3 or 4 times, whatever. Or who knows how many. You don't see. He's just like, hit me again. He's like...
Man, some of those hockey fights, they throw... Like fucking 14 jabs in a row, like just
Yeah, that was right. The night before that was that game where he stopped the goal with his face. You know, the other team, man. Then he gets, they're like, they keep smacking him in the face with their sticks, trying to get the puck in.
Yeah,
you know, and then somebody steps on his ankle and shit.
Oh, with the fucking skate.
Yeah. He's just getting the shit knocked out of him, man. It's not a fight. It's just, you know, they're playing hockey.
Yeah, it's just like being in a car crash.
I couldn't imagine.
Yeah, but with your face.
Yeah.
You're like guarding the entire net with your face.
I couldn't imagine. That sounds so terrible. The way they do that whenever he gets hit in the face and the blood squirts, they did it really good because it looks fucking real.
Yeah, it does. It looks, it's very cinematically appealing.
Right,
yeah,
exactly.
For sure.
It might not look real, but I enjoyed it in the movie. Man, earlier...
Real probably looks less impressive.
Yeah, probably.
Because when the hit happens, there's no blood spatter. It's like the hit happens, that opens a thing, and then that starts bleeding.
Right.
But it's more cinematic to...
Have that blood squirt out, of course. Yeah.
But it looked great, though. You're absolutely right. Like, all the punching and all the fights in this, I was like... Top shelf.
Right.
But also the like all the little jabs and shit that they do, it's kind of, it looks comical. I don't know if it's because of the pads or what the deal is, but something about it just is like giggling while it's happening.
Right. Yeah. I watch a lot of hockey and there's hockey fights, but you don't see fights like that anymore. You know, I don't know if they used to be like that really back in the day, but man, you're right. They get those little short ones whenever they got them, like, right underneath.
Jab, 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 jab.
Then they come around with the haymaker, whatever, man. It is good fighting. Man, earlier, I really enjoyed whenever the teams, they're not really doing well yet, and they're in those two Russian dudes are making fun of the goalie, and they got, oh, your mother over here.
Yeah.
He's got his mom's
just
face.
Pictures of his mom on his goalie mask. Right. And then he talks to her in the middle of the game. He's like, oh, he's going glove, mama. He's going glove.
Right.
Fucking just silly as shit. And then that guy, because he's, what did they say he is? He's like a Newfie. He's like from Newfoundland or whatever.
I don't remember.
I don't remember where he's from, but they're making fun of his accent, and he does have a very... But the other two guys are Russian, so, like, everybody has thick accents.
Right.
I like the guy who's getting divorced.
Yeah.
Man, that guy was really funny. Yeah. Was he team captain, I think?
He was the captain,
He just seemed like he was, like, 15 years older than everybody else there, and he's like, yeah, I'm getting divorced, like, all the time.
Yeah, and you
pass out in the middle of a speech because he's drunk at the bar.
Drinking the whole time, yeah. And then they're playing another game. three of those guys on that team are going through a divorce too. And they're just talking about people getting divorced.
His hype man, he's like, we're out there playing divorced guys, everybody.
His hype man's nonstop. Just,
oh man, he's great.
Amping him up, you know. Fuck repeating exactly word for word what he says.
You need anything, just tell me and he'll do it.
Right, yeah. Yeah, he leans over, don't hesitate. Yeah, they're in the bar and those Russian guys were saying, oh, let's see what you're working with. Show us your dick. We'll sign your dick or whatever they're saying. They're all one.
He's passed out drunk, and they're like, "Oh, let's sign his dick."
They're wanting to sign Glatt's dick.
Yeah,
you know.
He's like, "I'm not doing that." And he's like, "What? It's not gay. Yeah. We're brothers. We do it all the time." He's like, well, "My brother is gay, and he's never done that."
Exactly. Yeah, the goalies. Yeah, that's pretty gay.
Those guys are funny, man. When they're peeing in the piss hole in the. Also, what the fuck is that about? Just a piss hole in a bus?
I know. I don't know how old that's from. That's news to me.
Might be a Canadian thing. Write me, Canadians, at itsjustthemovies@gmail.com. Do you guys have a piss hole on chartered buses? That seems really weird.
It does seem really weird.
I mean, it doesn't seem that weird from like an engineering standpoint. Just pee in the hole. Right. Everything will be fine.
There's got to be piss all over that bus.
There's got to be piss all over the fucking backseat.
Not just the backseat, dude. They miss the hole. It rolls to the front. It looks like it's literally just a hole in the floor.
It is just not a hole like in the floor.
A little drop down not with even a little a toilet. Tub, nothing. You know, nothing there. It's just a literally
fucking,
a hole.
Just a fucking hole.
They're moving around on the bus, you know, and they're pushing each other on the bus. You know, that shit's going everywhere. Not shit. That piss is going everywhere.
Dude, and they're talking shit the whole time, too. They're like, oh, dicks haven't been this wet since we fucked your mom, goalie guy, or whatever. They just keep saying weird shit like it's right. A burn, but it just keeps being weirder and weirder.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Those guys are funny. This is a funny fucking movie.
I really enjoyed, all the bullshit they're giving each other the whole time.
All right, man. So, I mean, we're kind of about discussed a bunch of it. But I do want to talk about the fucking fight with Liev Schreiber, like the last game.
Yeah, man. Well, that's kind of bullshit, though. He's already fucked up before the fight even happens.
Eat that mic.
He's already fucked up before the fight even happens, you
He's
know?
He's super fucked up. You know? Face all fucking swelled up and shit. Big cuts and shit.
Yeah. He's at a disadvantage to start, and he's going to fight this badass, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But, man, they beat the shit out of each other.
It's bad. Yeah. I love the way, like, Liev Schreiber knocks him down. Fucking hard right hook. Throws Sean William Scott to the ice.
Yeah.
And as he's, like, fucking getting back up, the ref comes over and Liev Schreiber's like, don't you fucking dare.
Right, yeah. it's usually over at that point. You know?
They're fighting some more. And then Sean William Scott just, like, he's like, oh, I broke my ankle in like fucking 8 places or whatever. And then that guy stepped on his ankle with the ice skate.
Yeah, the night before, right?
Yeah, and then he's got that fucking fight and his fucking ankle just breaks.
Yeah.
And he gets up and fight. The ref comes up again after his ankle breaks and he gets knocked down a second time. And he's like, he's not done.
Right.
He gets up again and just finally knocks out Liev Schreiber. Like, knocks him out cold.
Right, yeah.
And then he falls to the ground and just starts screaming.
Right.
Because his ankle is fucking obliterated.
Right? Yeah, man, but it's brutal. Yeah.
It's the most unbelievable part of this movie is when he's in the locker room and his girlfriend is just like, oh, it's okay, Sean William Scott. And his ankle is broken in several places. Right. And there's like no doctor, no nothing. He's just like waiting right. in the fucking locker room.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Fucking crazy. So at the end of the match, though, when it's over, is it the one where he gets fucking hit in the face? Yeah, both teams rush the ice and just start beating the shit out of each other.
Yeah.
I would love to see that.
Oh, I know, dude. I've never seen a whole team, the whole bench clear. I've never seen that in a hockey.
That'd be crazy.
Yeah, it would be badass.
Yeah. That last fight, man, it's really fucking good. And then at the very end, Liev Schreiber like lifts his head up and he smiles. He's like, "Way to go, kid!" And he's missing a tooth. Yeah. It's hilarious, dude. That's good stuff. I really like this. How many hockey stick thumbs would you give this out of no, corn dogs. Let's do corn dogs.
Corn dog
thumbs. How many corn dog thumbs you give this out of 10 corn dog thumbs?
Man, I'll be honest with you. I really love this movie. It's going to get a higher score than maybe most. I'm going to give it a 9.
Oh, yeah?
I love this movie.
I was going to give it 8.5, man. This is a really fun comedy. Like, right. I would put this on anytime.
Yeah, for sure.
Anytime. This is a good one. I think I watched it on... Did I rent it? I think I rented it on Redbox, but you can watch it plenty of places ad-free. I don't think ads would really take the steam out of this too much because it's only an hour 30 anyway.
I watched it on Prime, Amazon Prime, for free.
Did you? Oh, okay. You had it on Prime for free. Nice. Yeah. You know what? I didn't even look at Prime. I just rented it. Fuck. Oh, I need to start keeping all my receipts for that shit. Should be a, because I can write that stuff off. Maybe someday I will. God damn it.
It's hard to
What's
keep
it
track
like
everything.
Being responsible? Is it cool? Write me at itsjustomovies@gmail.com. Let me know if being responsible is cool.
If it saves you money, it's cool.
Yeah. So we are going to go watch a different movie about Sean William Scott doing a thing. We thought about maybe watching Goon 2, Rise of the Enforcer, but I don't know. Just balls out seemed like more fun.
Right.
So we're going to go check that out. I'm going to have a glass of water, and we will be right back. Here's the interlude. Returning for the second half. Oh shit, wait, hold on. Returning for the second half. You like that? The little echo? Yeah. It's the same two dudes from earlier in the show, but one of them is more drunk. It's the second half of the podcast. Yay. Okay, there we go. That's enough exciting. Of that. So I just was trying something new out, you know, see how it.
I like it. I enjoy it.
See how it goes. You think it's, is it? Too hype or not hype enough?
It's probably not hype enough.
No, it's super cringe either way. That's what the kids would say. We watched Balls Out, colon, Gary the Tennis Coach.
Hell yeah, we did.
So yeah, little addendum to what we said earlier. I thought it was just called Balls Out, but no, it's Balls Out, colon, Gary the Tennis Coach. If you're not familiar with it, it is a R-rated 2009 comedy sport film, 1 hour, 33 minute runtime. We watched it on HBO. It's got a 5.4 out of 10 on IMDb, 3.4 out of 5 on Vudu, 2.3 out of 5 on Letterboxd. 54% of Google users like this movie.
Oh, Sean William Scott.
Was released in January 13th, directed by Danny Liner. Budget $15 million U.S. dollars. Produced by Sean William Scott, Danny Liner, John Panottoli. No, Panotti. Yeah, Panotti, that's what's up. Music composed by John Schwiart. Okay. Distributed by Sony Pictures. Starring Sean William Scott, Randy Quaid, Brando Eaton, Lenore Varela, A.D. Miles, Connor Donovan, Ryan Simpkins, and I guess a couple other people.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot of people that I would recognize on here.
Yeah, not really. I guess Meredith Eaton, she's in it quite a bit.
Emily Wallace. I'm not even sure who that is, but she's on there.
Yeah.
It's a weird picture here.
So, J-Bone, if someone had never seen Balls Out, colon, the first Gary of fucking tennis or whatever this is called.
It's the Gary, the tennis coach.
Gary, the tennis coach? Oh, yeah. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
What would you say this is about?
Well, what I'd tell him is that I got a buddy that has a podcast, and he's really good about, you know, telling people what stuff's about. And I would say, you should just listen to Danny tell you.
Oh.
And I feel like...
That's very clever what you've done there.
I feel like you've had a few drinks, so this might be entertaining.
So, boy, wow, I have had like... I'm like past the 12-pack. That happened a long time ago.
I know.
Whew. It's been a long couple weeks, Justin. I would say balls out, colon, Gary the tennis coach. It's mostly about a guy that loves tennis more than anything else. You know what? I think there's some good connective tissue between these two movies because this character also can only do one thing well.
Yeah, exactly. Play tennis.
Play tennis. And how that was a big theme in Goon was, you know, you're only good for one thing. People only want you for one thing. They want you to bleed.
Right, yeah.
But honestly, he hadn't really made it. Nobody had really made him bleed.
In Goon?
Yeah.
Just a couple of the fights towards the end. He had with that real big black dude that's an enforcer in the NHL, or used to be years ago.
Oh, yeah. They're getting ready to, the puck drop, and he's like, you want to go? And he's like, oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. And he's like, okay. And they're just like, it's such an agreeable fight over nothing. They're just like, let's have a good fight.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and then, of course, the dude at the end, you know.
So that's what I would say balls out Gary the tennis coach is about how the other one was better. But honestly, like, now I'll be being fucking for real. This one was way more fun.
Right.
It was so fucking stupid. It was so stupid is what was made, what actually made it better, I think.
Right.
Okay, Gary, the tennis coach, he's like, I've been trying to get away from tennis my whole life. And God damn it, old lady tennis, she's not been good to me. And then he does. So he becomes a janitor at a high school where they have a tennis team. And he's like, as long as tennis never comes running back to me, I'm done with that old bitch. And then he's watching kids play tennis, and one of them hits a ball over the thing. And he's like, it rolls right up to his feet. He's like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Right. And he's like, oh no, now I'm back in on tennis. And he fucking coaches some rando high school tennis team or whatever.
It's like some small town.
Yeah. And then it's very Remember the Titans. Only imagine that Denzel Washington is like an alcoholic who's down with hookers and got fucked by a donkey at some point in his life.
Right?
Yeah.
Man, yeah, and you got Randy Quaid, which is the other coach, the main coach.
Oh.
Which is great. He's sitting there giving his, he's talking so much shit to the kids, he don't give a shit, you know?
Dude, my favorite part with Randy Quaid is the bit where Randy Quaid and Sean William Scott are in the bathroom. They're in the men's. And Sean William Scott, he's the janitor. So he's like scooping out bubble gum and fucking cigarettes out of the urinal. And Randy Quaid's sitting there talking to him and he spits gum in the urinal. And then he lights up a cigarette. But he comes out of the bathroom. He comes out of the bathroom with a donut in his mouth and a newspaper. Yeah. So he was in there taking a shit, eating a donut.
Yeah. Just sets it down.
Sets it down. Doesn't wash his hands. And then fucking spits the gum in the fucking urinal, smokes a cigarette, and then throws that in the urinal and flushes it.
Right.
Right. And man, he's such a dick. And it's a home run.
Right.
It's a home run. The whole scene, any scene with him in it is fucking immaculate.
My favorite part of it is when he's the owl at the very end, I think. That is at the very end of the movie. Because he dies.
Oh.
He has a heart attack in the middle of
class. When he's an owl?
Or when he's an owl, yes.
Oh, my fucking God.
At the very end.
Dude, I love it so much. It's just an owl sitting on a bit of fence, and they have very poorly put Randy Quaid's face on top of it, and man, it's gold.
It is.
It's gold. What else did you like about it? So they win the tennis championship or whatever, and it's he's fucking with kids.
Yeah.
It's the whole thing. There's a bit where he's like, oh, he gets that kid that's like his star or whatever that's going to he's going to play the other kid from the other big school or whatever.
Have a hockey match.
Yeah.
Not a hockey match. Having tennis. A tennis match.
And he's like, oh, yeah. He's like, oh, you're not scared? And he's like, no, I'm not scared. And he's like, oh, yeah, I'll tell you what, we're here to make you a man tonight, and you're going to drink a beer. And he's okay. He succumbs to the peer pressure. He's drinking a beer. And then he's like, yeah, we're going to, you know why you're not afraid to beat that guy? It's because he's a boy, and you're a man. And then a hooker comes in. Not right. a stripper, a hooker.
Right.
And it's just this guy gets a high school kid a hooker. It's a very fun scene.
Yeah, it's the whole time it's like he has no idea what's appropriate and what's not appropriate, you know, because it's a high school. At one point, he is living in a camper on the street next to the school.
Oh, yeah.
And he comes out, you know, that he's making his power drink or whatever, and he takes his jock strap off. He cracks the fucking egg. He puts the egg in there and then throws the whole fucking shell in there.
Oh, that protein shake's nasty as shit. And just all the beef jerky you could ever imagine.
Yeah, he pulls his jock strap off and squeezes the sweat into it. It's so gross. But later, he's in his jock strap, and he runs out because he sees kids...
being afraid of the ball.
Exactly. He comes out, his ass hanging out, nothing but his jock strap, and starts hitting the kids with the tennis balls.
Yeah.
And then...
I like that bit, because he's like, why are you fucking afraid? You're afraid of these? And he fucking just belts them.
Right.
Just belts these kids with these fucking tennis balls.
Right.
And then he stops, and he's like, why are you crying? Stop crying. He's like, are you hurt? And he's like, well, no. And the other guy, how about you? You fucking hurt? No. All right, then. Then let's fucking, you know, get after it and fucking put some extra work in.
It was a weird way to do it, but it was actually a really valuable lesson for him.
Yeah. I liked A.D. Miles in this. He plays the assistant coach, the guy who's like always ratting out Sean William Scott.
Yeah.
I recognize him mostly from the movie Role Models.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He's one of the sturdy wings.
Man, it's been so long since I've seen Role Models. I remember bits and pieces of it, but I have watched it.
The charity that they work for is Sturdy Wings. Right. Alicia's got a Sturdy Wings t-shirt.
Does she?
I got it for her.
Nice.
People are like, oh, that's a good charity. it's from Role Models.
Nice. Hell yeah.
Mm. And you don't need a drug dependency when you have Sturdy Wings or whatever the slogan is. I don't know. It's dumb. Man, fun movie, though. I'm fucking digging this. What's another thing I really liked? His little romance with the Spanish teacher. I thought that was fun.
Yeah, man.
Thought she just kind of like met his level of fucking weird.
Right? Yeah. Yeah, she... There's all the time. He makes up that he got kicked out of school for finger banging her, you know, got suspended or whatever. And then she's like, she's mad about it. But then she's like, but I like the fingers, and she's making the motion.
Yeah. He's like, huh?
Yeah.
Man, I might have said this earlier. It must be exhausting always getting typecast to play a fucking idiot.
You did, and I agree.
Do you think Sean William Scott could do like dramatic or like a period piece or something?
Man, it'd be so hard to see him in anything other than what he plays all the time.
But yeah,
I mean, I bet he probably could.
I think it'd be refreshing, man.
I'd like to see him
in a period piece, like, you know, a movie about knights or whatever, or just like any grubby ass thing like that.
Yeah, I'd like to see him in something different. I was wondering that because
he's funny. He really is. Like, he's funny.
Yeah, all I ever see him in is stuff like that. You know, he's Stifler.
There's no way that he's been in that many funny roles. And he's not funny. It's just the writing. There's right. no way, because they all typecast him for the same fucking thing.
Yeah, the way he delivers it, it's all, he does a really good job, I think.
Yeah.
But yeah, I would like to see him in something different. I'm not sure.
I want to see him as like a, like if there's something coming down the pipe that's sort of like the movie Seven, I'd like to see him in like Brad Pitt's role.
Right, yeah.
The rookie, like the fresh detective working with the seasoned veteran or whatever.
Right. Man, didn't he, what was it? Was he in Chips? Is that what he was in? What was he in? Wasn't he a cop in something?
He's not in Chips. He's, what is he a cop in? He's not in Chips. That's fucking a different guy. God damn it. What's his name? He's got a podcast, too. It's called Armchair Specialist or something. Dax Shepard, yeah.
Okay. Man, I can't remember. It feels like he's a cop in something, but I can't remember what the hell it is now.
Man, he is a cop in something, too. I don't know what, though. Or maybe it's the Mandela effect. I don't know.
I don't have any
idea. Maybe he was never a cop.
He might not have been.
He could have been Batman.
He...
He could have been Batman. If they would have rebooted Sean William Scott as Batman in that fucking, in the last of the Batman movie, right, that Matt Reeves Batman movie, it would have repainted both of them in a different light. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true.
Batman and Sean William Scott.
I agree. I would.
It
like
wouldn't
to
have
see...
been bad. I mean, like, I know he's like got brown hair. If I can give him a little touch of Just for Men,
right?
It'd be all right. He's fine. Got the jawline for it for sure.
Yeah, he does.
The physique, I think probably. I don't know how tall Sean William Scott is.
I'm not sure, but I think
I tell you this: he can act like a drunk jackass. So can I, evidently. but he can act like a drunk jackass, which is my favorite Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
Good drunk Bruce all the time.
Good drunk Bruce all the time.
All the time.
All the time. Wow.
You... Dude.
Man, it's a shame I can't drunk Bruce Wayne all the time. That almost was really, really bad. You guys.
That's a glass bottle.
I threw a glass beer bottle at the trash can. I totally missed because it's a wooden bucket. Here's a little peek behind the curtain. The bottle glanced off the outside of the wooden bucket, danced along the rim, and shot straight towards my guitar foot pedal, which has several metal buttons on it and has like a fucking steel or aluminum housing with a powder coat. So just a big flat fucking surface full of pokey shit that would love to break a glass bottle. Totally missed all that and just hit the carpet. And I'm going to leave it there until we're done recording. You have my word. I'm going to grab a beer real quick, though. Unrelated. Anyway.
That was a close one.
Rawson.
Hell yeah. Get you a beer, man.
Tell me, J-Bone.
I'm going to tell you.
What else?
What else did I like about this movie?
Yes.
What else did I like about this movie? That's a good question, since I need to think about the movie we watched. You know, I actually did really enjoy it. It was funny. There was a lot of laughs. I'll tell you one of my favorite parts.
Yes.
Was the... hold on a second. Was that dude Chinese or the grandpa? The grandpa. Fucking love the grandpa.
Yeah.
The foreign kid, his grandpa, when he's...
He looks like a goat. He's just having his he's just got a contagious laugh.
He does, yeah.
Is what it is.
He's always mimicking him, how he hits the tennis ball so hard. Mm-hmm. He does that 3 or 4 times throughout the whole movie.
Oh, God, it's funny. And he's dying, man. He is. That old man. Dude, he is laughing so fucking hard. Like, it is contagious because he's just fucking cracking the fuck up.
Right. He's wanting him to live with him. He's wanting one of the foreign kids that's coming, whatever, to be on the tennis team to live with him. He's like, ask your dad. And he's like, I don't know what he says about his dad. He's like, well, ask your grandpa. And he's like, yeah, we lived in one room with 8 families. Yeah, he can live here.
Yeah.
He didn't give a shit, but man, that grandpa, he had me cracking up.
Dude, he's funny as shit. I really liked the... I really liked the... just the stupid Sean William Scott shit about this. When he's sitting next to the coach's daughter on the bench, and he's like, hey, which one of these guys are you scoping on, huh? I just need to know so I can coach around it. Which one of them are they trying to knock you up? You taking that shit raw dog? And then she's like, actually, I'm the coach's daughter. And he's like, oh, I didn't mean to make it seem that you looked like a slut.
Right.
It's a terrible interaction. But he's like, that's how he talks to everybody.
Right. Yeah. That goes back to him not knowing, having any idea what's appropriate or what's not.
Oh, Gary's a fun character.
He really is.
I like him.
I wouldn't like him if I had a daughter, you know, that age that he's practically hitting on. He makes out with her later in the show, too.
He makes out with that girl?
Yeah, she tries to kiss him at the dance.
Ah.
She does kiss him, but I didn't see where it went from
there. I thought that was the teacher.
No, not at the, he made out with the teacher later, I think. But no, at the dance, they were in there, because she walked off after And what the fuck were they doing? They were dancing. The dances and him dancing on the dance floor was pretty damn interesting.
That was good. Oh my God, when he started a mosh pit.
Yeah, the mosh pit. Exactly. Pushing these kids in high school.
Oh my God, man. Funny as shit. Right. He's like, go out there and express yourself. And they're playing something like, you know, instrumental and fucking kind of funky or whatever. And he gets out there and he's breaking it down. And then the song ends and it changes to a fucking heavy metal song. And all the kids are still dancing the same dance. But he just starts moshing and pushing kids. And at first they're like, what the fuck, man? And then they just start all slamming into each other. They're just slam dancing, you know what I mean? God damn it, it's funny. Because he's the janitor at a high school.
Right, yeah. Yeah,
starting a mosh pit at the prom or whatever dance. It's not a prom, but...
Well, he's there as a chaperone because the teacher that he's wanting to bang is in there.
Yeah.
And him trying to speak Spanish to her is great, too.
Oh.
He knows a few phrases, and half of those are wrong.
You're looking muy bonita.
And she's speaking Spanish the whole time, so you know he's not understanding most of what she says.
Well, I think she speaks English, isn't it?
Does she?
Yeah, I think so.
She speaks a lot of Spanish. Maybe it's just when they're in the class.
Yeah, maybe. I'll be honest with you, the storyline portion of this, pretty boring.
Right, yeah.
Pretty boring. Comedy's pretty good,
yeah,
in my opinion, for a quick watch while I'm hammered.
Right, yeah, you're not going to... It's not the greatest movie in the world, but it is. Nah, it's good for some laughs.
You know, if you're going to drink some beers and you just want to have some background racket on, it's a good choice.
Yeah.
How many tennis ball thumbs would you give it?
Tennis ball thumbs. I would go... Man, I really liked it. I'm gonna go a 7.5.
I was gonna go 8.
Yeah.
It's not so bad, it's good.
Right.
If it was, like, if a tennis ball was like a little animated sock puppet monster sometimes, then yes, right. this would be a whole lot closer to a 10.
Right. Yeah.
But this is like a fun comedy. This is a fun buddy comedy. It was really hard to pair a movie with Goon, okay? Right. It was hard to do. You try it. You think of a better one and you write me at itsjusttwomovies@gmail.com and we will fucking just do that as a bonus episode. It'd just be, it's just one movie.
That attaches to Goon.
Yeah, that you want us to cover. Yeah, if you've got a better one, lay it on me. I would love to know because I racked my brain for like 2 days straight trying to think of something that would work for this.
Right. Yeah, well, that's what I was saying. I said you can do something with Sean William Scott. This one is also sports related, so I think it works pretty good.
It's myself. A Sean William Scott sports movie where he's only good at one thing.
Yeah.
He's not bad. But I don't know, man. That's all I've got for that. Next segment of the show.
Hey, what you watching?
What you watching, J-Bone?
What am I watching? Man, I've been watching a lot of Boardwalk Empire. I'm on...
Okay. I've heard good things, but I've never watched Boardwalk Empire.
You haven't? Man, you should watch Boardwalk Empire. And I can't think of the dude's name that is awesome in it. Just a second.
Is it Corey Stoll? Paul Giamatti?
No. I don't know his name. It's a guy that I... didn't know until...
Carlos Esposito.
No.
Carlo Esposito.
It's Michael Shannon. I can't ever think of his name. Oh, fuck,
I love Michael Shannon.
He's fucking awesome in that, dude.
He's fucking awesome in just about everything he's ever been in.
Right.
Have you ever seen Man of Steel? He's the best part of Man of Steel.
Is he? No, yeah. I haven't. I'm not. Yeah, I haven't watched a whole lot of DC stuff, so I haven't watched a whole lot of Superman. Yeah, I'm on season 5 of that, so that's all there is, 5 seasons, but man, that show is freaking brutal. Holy good shit. Stuff. It's really good, yeah, but it's you know, it's a prohibition era, you know, it's, and it's just so much violence in that.
God damn, I wish I'd lived during the prohibition, because I'd have made a shitload of money.
Yeah, you also could have got killed Like, so many people dying in that show.
Yeah, that's fucking crazy, isn't it? They murdered people over booze.
Right? Yeah, nonstop. Man, it's been a while since I've been on. I've watched the all of Letterkenny.
Nice.
I finished that.
How are you now?
Good. You?
Oh, not so bad.
Yeah. Dude, I love Letterkenny. I
had so many beers, pert near put my truck in the ditch.
Yeah, dude, Letterkenny, that's very good. Really enjoyed that. You know, I've been playing a shitload of EverQuest again. That gets me every so many years. I go play that some more.
Yeah, I get it.
I've been playing it for like 6 months now.
I get it. There'll be a point in the next 5 years where I'm like, I went back and played Pokemon Red.
Right?
Yeah. that's always a throwback for me. Like every so many years, I'm like, I'm just going to give it another go.
Right.
But it's just a game I beat like fucking 9 times.
Right.
It's
really
just a comfort game.
Yeah, for sure.
I enjoy it. It's fun. It's easy. I've already broken the mechanic a million times. It's not like I can't just waltz right through it, because I can.
Right.
But I just enjoy it's fun gameplay.
Yeah, for sure. I haven't played any of the Pokemon games, I'll be honest with you.
Never?
No.
Oh, man.
None of them.
One of the handhelds would probably knock your socks off.
Probably. I just, for whatever reason, never did get into the Pokemon.
Do you ever get into a turn-based? Do you like a turn-based?
I used to.
It's their turn now. It's my turn now. Yeah, it's their turn. I'm
very familiar with it, like Final Fantasy type stuff originally. Yeah, yeah. Used to love that kind of stuff. Final Fantasy 1, 2, and 3. Loved Final Fantasy 3. It was probably one of my favorite games back in the day.
Nice.
But yeah, I never did get into Pokemon for whatever reason.
Yeah, man, I liked the original two, and then I played like one of the next ones that came out, and then they missed me for like 15 years. And then I got back out on them and on the Switch.
Right.
Anyway, what have I been up to, man? I watched...
You're working a lot.
Yes. I have been watching... There is something I've been watching. Let me think of it. I watched a movie called The Monster. A horror movie called The Monster.
Okay.
It was okay. I was cracking jokes the whole time. Like, it turned out the monster was inside us the whole time. But it was okay. There was a titular monster. I liked the look of it.
Okay.
It wasn't doing anything I hadn't seen before, but I thought it was pretty well done for what it was. Acting in it's really good. That's noteworthy. Like, the performances in it are really something.
Okay. What do you think of Nathan Fillion?
I like Nathan Fillion.
Man, have you watched his show, The Rookie?
No.
It's on TV like now.
Really? Know. What's it on?
I don't know. It's on, I don't know what streaming service it's on.
Peacock?
It might be. It's one of those. It's on, I don't know, Channel 5 or some shit, you know?
It would be.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know what it is. That show, we watch that a lot. I say we watch a lot. We watch it every week when it comes out, you know. That show I really like. But it's him, you know, it's your typical sitcom cop show, you know. He's a rookie cop, you know. Well, he's not a rookie now. It's been on for 4 or 5 years, you know.
Yeah. How are you on like sci-fi stuff?
I don't watch a ton of it.
Well, Nathan Fillion is the lead role in a show called Firefly that is critically very well received. I watched it, I enjoyed it, and I watched the subsequent film that came out before or after it.
Right.
And I enjoyed that as well. Enjoyed the whole saga, like, a lot.
Right.
You could tell it was, like, budgetarily speaking, it really looked like Battlestar Galactica or any of that kind of daytime sci-fi shit. But right. the show and the writing and the characters and the performances, I thought it was a pretty good show.
Right. Yeah, well, I've always been a fan of his, and I haven't actually watched that. I actually have the whole series. I just haven't ever watched it. I'm not a huge...
You have it? Like a physical copy?
Yeah.
Dude, yeah. You should let me borrow that.
Okay, yeah.
I'll watch it with my kid.
Yeah. I have it. Yeah, it's not really long.
It's got fucking Marina Baccarin in it. It's a good show.
Yeah, it's got. Is it only one season? It's not long.
Yeah, it's not long. It might be two. I don't remember off the top of my head. It's been a long time since I've seen it, but it left an impression on me. I liked it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Ryan's buying shit all the time, left and right, video games and movies and stuff. I found it at a flea market or something. It's the series, you know?
Yeah, it's a good one. Check it out if you get time. If you do like three episodes and you're not into it, drop it.
I mean, I imagine I'd be into it enough just because I'm a fan of his. I liked when he did Castle and all that.
Dude, one I'm really looking forward to is fucking, God damn it, what's it called? I am really looking forward to, fuck, I've totally lost it.
Perry Mason.
I do want to watch Perry Mason. I watched one episode of it and I was like, this isn't bad. And then I just never went back. But it, like, the original Perry Mason is, like, my dad's favorite show.
Right? Dude.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I've done some service calls where I've been on jobs where old people are watching that show still, just black and white on the TV.
It's a good show.
Yeah. They,
it's a good show.
They love that shit.
I mean, for my two cents, it's no Columbo. But it's good.
Oh, yeah? I've never watched it, to be honest with you. I'm familiar with it. I know they did a remake not that long ago on something, and I tried watching it then, Showtime or something.
That's it. It's HBO, I think.
Well, it's on HBO now, so I don't know if this is just an...
Oh, a different one?
I thought this was a different one.
Hmm. I watched one episode, and I was quite into it. I think in this one, Perry Mason's just kind of a mess. Oh, like, yeah. He's an alcoholic, like a manic depressive alcoholic.
Right. Yeah, that's what I watched. I guess that is the same one that I watched. I didn't realize it was the same thing. I thought it was a different one even.
Yeah.
I've been seeing stuff about it here recently. You were trying to figure out what you've been wanting to watch, and I seen it come up, so that's why I said something about it.
Nice.
Trying to figure out what the hell I've been watching, because it's been months.
Dude, fucking me too, man. It's been a week.
Well, I know what you've been watching.
But I'm like, it's why it's normally not that hard for me to think of something, because I'm like, well, I watched it this week. Let me think back.
Right.
But, man, it hasn't been a lot. I watched half of The Old Way, starring Nicolas Cage.
Okay.
It's like a Western based on a novel that Birdman read, and he said the book was quite good. And we were very excited to see how the movie panned out. And then as it finally debuted, he was like, ooh, turns out it's not that good. Really? And I gotta tell you, it's good in the best way.
Oh, yeah?
We recently did the movie Old Henry, and I really wish we would have done that as an accompaniment to it, because it would have been perfect.
Really? Old Henry, has that come out yet?
No, it comes out Monday as we're recording this.
I gotcha.
Yeah, so it hasn't come out just yet. I have yet to even edit any of it, so I'm really looking forward to doing all that tomorrow.
Have you seen absolutely anything, Simon Pegg?
Oh, yeah, a long time ago.
Is it real old?
It's older
Prime.
For sure. I remember it being a fun movie. Like, it didn't knock my socks off, but I have positive feelings about it when you say it.
Yeah, I watched
it.
He
gets like some sort of alien power or something where he can make anything happen.
Yeah, anything he says, he just says and does. Whatever he says, it just happens, you know? I watched it the other night. Like I said, it wasn't nothing great, but it was decent.
Yeah, he did a handful of those off the back of the Shaun of the Dead.
I gotcha.
A handful of just like mediocre, okay, rom-com-y kind of things. Yeah, I remember that being a fun one, though. I mean, as far as those go.
Man, have you watched Tulsa King? I know this is supposed to be on what I've been watching. I haven't actually watched that, but I had a buddy tell me that
it can be what you're gonna. It can be what you're gonna watch. That's fine. I have not seen Tulsa King. Somebody said it was awesome.
It's like their new favorite show.
No shit.
It's a dude from Texas I play EverQuest with.
Oh, that sounds about right.
Right.
That sounds about right.
That's what I thought.
That sounds about right, Justin's friend from Texas.
Yeah.
What's it? Who's in it, though? Does it have Stallone?
Yeah.
It's a show?
Yeah.
All right.
I started watching the first episode, and it's like he's, I don't know if it's mafia or whatever it is, and he's been in jail for 20-something years for a murder that he didn't do or whatever. And so now he's out, and they're going to send him to Tulsa, I guess.
To be the king of Tulsa?
Yeah.
That sounds all right.
Yeah, like
I ain't mad at that.
He's gonna run that area, you know. They don't have a branch of whatever he's in. I don't think it's mafia. It's whatever it is.
Some sort of organized crime type
exactly.
of deal.
Exactly. Yeah.
I got you.
So I haven't seen that, but that's one I was wanting to check out. You know,
man. As far as playing stuff, I really meant to get into another thing this week, and I just did not have the time, so I have still been playing Marvel Snap.
Yeah, man. I have not been playing Marvel Snap.
I know. Yeah, no, nobody has. Nobody has. It's just me and, like, some other nerds on here. That's
I gotta be honest with you. I played it a little bit, and I actually did enjoy it, but card games like that, they don't hold my attention very long. But that card game, what I did play, I actually enjoyed it. I just playing so much other shit, you know, having time to do whatever. You know, it was nice because, like you said, they're short matches. But just keeping my attention, dude, I get to play another shit.
Not quite doing it for you. No, I get it. Man, believe me when I say a fucking... I wish there was another thing that I had time to fucking play.
Right.
Like, I just been so busy the last couple of weeks. I started playing that Guardians of the Galaxy game,
right,
which is not terribly long. And I really would like to finish it because I played like 3.5 hours of it. And I was like, okay, I'm into this. And
well, let me tell you, I'm pretty sure that's coming off of Game Pass. So if you want to finish that, you might want to get on that pretty quick.
Okay. All right. Will do. I will try to do it tomorrow after I get done with all my editing. Jesus fucking Christ. I got so much shit to do on my days off. It's wild.
I think
I'm not looking forward to when the grass grows and I have to also start mowing the lawn.
Right.
I'm just like, great. There's an extra 3 hours of my week gone.
Right. Yeah. Gotta love the grass. Yeah, I'm not looking forward to that either. I don't love mowing the grass.
I don't mind it. Actually, it's quite relaxing because it's a lot. It's just a lot of it that I'm doing is just a big open area.
Right.
But boy, it takes a lot of time.
Yeah, you got a lot to do.
Yeah, and that I don't have. But I don't know. Yeah, well, I'll fucking figure it out.
There is one other thing I've been playing.
Yeah.
I got into The Last of Us.
Ooh.
I'm finally getting further along. I'm not real far yet. I'm 4 or 5 hours in.
Ooh. Okay. So you're into gameplay now.
Oh, yeah. Pretty, yeah.
Yeah.
Into it pretty good. I don't know. I might not be 4 or 5 hours in, but
are you playing it on easy difficulty?
Yeah.
Or?
Just playing it on easy. Yeah.
Nice.
So everything, you know, it has... I almost want to...
When you double the distance you're at, it still is like, okay, whoa, I got to think about this first. How do I... It becomes very, like, resources are very
so
limited.
It is going to get harder once...
Oh, yeah. But on normal, resources are scarce like that the whole game.
Right. Well, that's what I was saying. It's like, it's almost too easy now. Because I'm, like, the clickers, I'm running around them, and they're cool, you know. And I'm like, man, I don't want to...
But you can just sneak right by him.
Yeah, just walk through like it's nothing, you know? So it's almost too easy, but I am enjoying, because obviously been watching the show, you know, not talking about that, but obviously we talk, you know, about that.
Yeah, on our Patreon content, which the link for is in our episode description. Check it out.
Right. So I've been wanting to play the game more to see how it goes with the story of the show because I've been loving the show.
Yeah.
And man, there's some differences obviously, but it's pretty damn good.
Yeah.
I like how some of the similarities are. Excited to get further along.
Oh man. Me too. I think there's only 2 episodes left.
Yeah. 2 episodes of the show. Yep.
Oh man. I'm like amped for season 2 But as soon as it's over, I'm going to replay the game, and then I'm going to play The Last of Us Part 2, which I have not ever played.
Right.
But I'm wondering if I should wait and watch the show first, because it was renewed for season 2, so.
For sure.
I don't know. We'll find out and see how it goes. Anything else that you'd like to add to what we're watching?
Nah, I think that's good.
I think me neither. In the meantime, to contact the show, write us at itsjusttwomovies.com or follow us at itsjusttwomovies on other social networks or, you know, if you want to support the show, there's lots of places you can do that in the episode description. You can buy us a coffee. That shit's fucking awesome. That's just a throw me a buck because you love me. You can support our Patreon, in which case you can get more shit for. Episodes come out 2 to 3 days early on there. I eventually would like to make it 3 to 4 days early, but I've had some scheduling conflicts with other stuff lately, so we'll just see how that goes. You can also click our Amazon affiliate link while you're doing your shopping, and we get a kickback from that as well. That helps us financially. We appreciate you listening. Appreciate you leaving a 5-star review. I appreciate you telling a friend. Appreciate you, like, getting somebody that you think would like the show and then capturing them, taking them to your basement, and gagging them and peeling their eyeballs open and making them watch our YouTube videos.
Yeah.
And like and subscribe. That's also very helpful.
You got to use their phone for that also.
It helps like-minded people find the show when you do things like that. So you can do it right there in app on Apple. Or There you go. It helps like-minded people find the show, and we certainly do appreciate that. I think that's all I've got. For this week,
I think that's gonna do it.
All right. Well, oh, this is awkward. What do we do?
You guys aren't gonna start sucking each other's dicks, are you?
I call that bold talk for a one-eyed Batman.
Can I make a suggestion that doesn't involve violence, or is this the wrong crowd?
Maybe we should call in a bomb threat to Houston. I think it's free beer night at the Astrodome.
The Jedi, Bob, we don't fight with guns, we fight with our mind.
Cousin, business is out. Booming.
That is one big pile of shit.
Jog on.
It's Just Two Movies is a production of Blue Cheese and Bacon Studios and can be found wherever you get your podcasts.
Special thanks to the people who helped make this show. That is going to be Lamplighter Productions for our artwork, God-Sized and Growing for some musical guest appearances, Russ Tafari for some of our extra bonus content, music stuff. I'd also like to throw out a special thanks to Brad Sexton for our jams for the main show. You can check out his stuff at sons.bandcamp.com. And special thanks to Dave, who's our YouTube editor. Probably wouldn't even be on that platform were it not for Dave, so mad thanks to that homeboy. If you want to check out anything that any of these amazing people are working on, you can find that information in the episode description for this episode or any other. And I think that's going to wrap it up. Returning for the second half. Oh, shit. Wait, hold on. Returning for the second half. You like that? The little echo? Yeah. It's the same two dudes from earlier in the show. But one of them is more drunk. It's the second.